Scientists are looking into sustainably powering entire cities, and with liquid-based redox flow batteries, we're one step closer to making that happen. If we're ever going to replace fossil fuels with renewable sources like solar and wind power, then we're going to need a way to store energy for when it's dark and not windy, or just for when the demand for power exceeds the output. If you're familiar with any sort of electronic device, then there is one pretty obvious answer. Batteries. Charge them up when demand is low but output is high, then let the juice loose when that flips. There are different battery types, and all have their own strengths and weaknesses. The best battery for a job like this might be one that uses flowing liquids, called a redox flow battery. A redox flow battery is sort of a hybrid between a battery and a fuel cell. It consists of two tanks of an electrolyte liquid, one positive and one negative. In between the tanks is a cell stack where the positive and negative solutions are pumped, but kept separated by a membrane. Inside the cell stack, the ions in the negatively charged solution give up an electron, a process called oxidation. Those electrons are picked up by an electrode in the cell stack, and they travel through whatever needs to be powered before arriving at another electrode on the other side of the membrane. There, the ions in the positive solution pick up the electrons, a process called reduction. This frees up positively charged hydrogen ions, which travel back across the membrane and maintain the charge balance. When charging up, the entire process happens in reverse. But hold up, why go through all this when we already have lithium-ion batteries? You know, the ones in cell phones, laptops, electric cars, and oh yeah, household battery packs designed for exactly this purpose. The problem is that while big old lithium-ion batteries might be suitable for your house, they don't scale up well for something as big as an entire city. Lithium isn't an abundant material either, so it's not sustainable to use it in these huge applications. And anyone who's had the same phone for more than a couple years can tell you that lithium-ion batteries degrade and lose their ability to hold a charge over time. On the other hand, flow batteries can have qualities that make them perfect for large-scale power storage, like scalability. Need to store more energy? Just get bigger tanks that hold more solution. That's it. Worried about degradation? Some electrolyte solutions used in redox flow batteries can last for about 5,000 charge cycles, 5 times longer than lithium-ion batteries. What about price and sustainability? About that. The most popular metal used in redox flow batteries is vanadium because it charges and discharges reliably for thousands of cycles. But the cost of vanadium is rising, and if vanadium redox flow batteries go mainstream, that price could skyrocket. Researchers have tried to replace vanadium with organic molecules, but those tend to degrade and need replacement every few months, or the solution they're in has to be very acidic or basic, which can damage pumps or be hazardous in case of a leak. But scientists are undeterred, and recently researchers from USC announced organic water-based redox batteries that can last for about 15 years at 1/10 the cost of a lithium-ion battery. So far, the battery they've made is enough for the basic electricity demands of a single house, but their goal is to one day have electricity on tap for entire megacities. The technology is promising enough that China is building a massive vanadium redox flow battery with a storage capacity of 800 megawatt hours. That's enough for thousands of homes. The battery is scheduled to come online by 2020. China has plenty of vanadium reserves, so they're not too concerned about its cost, but if organic flow cell batteries become comparable, those might not be too far behind. One day, in the near future, they might play a vital role in green energy grids around the world. If you like this, subscribe, and then maybe watch this cool video about how we make batteries out of diamonds. And fun fact, while vanadium may not be the future of redox flow batteries, it is super cool. When vanadium gains electrons, it changes color, going from yellow to blue to green and finally purple. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.